Good morning, children. So let's begin today's session. This is English for class 8, and today we are going to learn what is active voice and passive voice. And this is for 12th January. This session is for 12th January. Today is 12th January, children. So let's begin. Let's read all the sentences given here. Andrew is delivering a lecture. Somebody has killed an elephant. They served the lunch to the guests. Then they served the lunch to the guests. After that, what is the next sentence? Jenny's grandparents looked after her. All the sentences given here are in active voice. Now, in active voice, we put the subject, that is the doer of the verb. The one who's doing something is the doer. Okay, that comes first in the sentence. In active voice, you have to remember this. Okay, then things will be very easy for you to understand. The doer of the subject is in the focus of attention. That means the one who's doing something is the doer. So, in active voice, that comes first in the sentence. Very easy to remember. Active voice indicates that the subject is acting or doing something in the active voice, and the recipient of the action is now in the focus. So let us see what next one. Okay, active voice. A verb is said to be in the active voice when the subject is the doer of the action. That comes first in the sentence, the one who's doing the action. Yes, the children broke the window pane. Who broke the children? They are the doer of the action. They are doing that action of what breaking. So that comes first in the sentence. That is the subject. So therefore, this is active voice. Very easy to remember. The doer of the action comes first in the sentence. This much you remember, it will be easy for you to remember what is active voice. Next one, children. A lecture is being delivered by Andrew. An elephant was killed. The entire house has been cleaned by Martha. The lunch was served by Laura. She was looked after by her grandparents. All the sentences given here are in passive voice. Now, in passive voice, the person or thing that the action was done to becomes the topic, now the passive subject. We may present the doer of the action within a prepositional phrase. Yes, by plus doer. That is what? In certain cases, we may even leave out the doer of the action. Because why? It is understood. That is why. Passive voice. A verb is said to be in the passive voice when the subject is the receiver of the action. The window pane was broken by the children. Yes, what is the subject? The window pane. The receiver becomes first in the action. So that is why this is passive voice. Change of voice from active to passive. You must know this, children. Yes. Swapping of a subject and object. The object in the active voice becomes the subject in the passive voice, and the subject in the active voice becomes the object in the passive voice. Let's see. The literary club presented a play. A play was presented by the literary club. See, the first sentence is in active. Who's the doer? The literary club. That means the members. Yes. Now, see, what happens in passive voice? A play was presented by the literary club. The object of the sentence becomes the subject of the sentence. See how the interchange happens. Look at it very carefully, you will understand. You understood? What happens in passive? Object becomes the subject of the verb. Okay, now, changing of pronouns. If the subject or the object is a pronoun, it changes in the manner described in the table given below. So you have to by heart this. You have to remember, I changes to me, we changes to us, you to you, he changes to him, you remains you only. She changes to her, it remains the same, it, they changes to them. These are some of the rules you must remember, okay? Otherwise, you are likely to go wrong. See, examples. Active voice, passive voice. I write a letter is written by me. We write a letter is written by us. You write a letter is written by you. See, you remains the same. He writes a letter is written by him. He changes into him. She writes a letter is written by her. So she changes into her. It eats the food. The food is eaten by it. Again here, it remains the same, it. They write a letter is written by them. They changes into them. Changing of pronouns. What happens? When the agent is important, we use the preposition by to introduce the doer of the agent. We may omit the what? Agent. Yes. Now, see, look here. The criminal was arrested by the police. If you write the criminal was arrested also, it is correct. Right? It is understood. Who will arrest? The police, of course. If one feels that the agent is understood from the context, one may omit the agent. So if you write this much only, it is understood the criminal was arrested. It is understood that police arrested the criminal. Passive verb forms and usages. Let's have a look at this. Simple present tense. Am is are plus past participle. Active. Diana drinks a glass of milk every day. Passive. A glass of milk is drunk by Diana every day. Simple past tense, was, were, plus past participle. Some examples. I wrote a letter to the manager yesterday. A letter was written to the manager yesterday. Simple future tense, shall, will, plus be, plus past participle. Now the example, I will complete the work soon, the work will be completed soon. Simple future tense. Present continuous tense, am, is, are, plus be plus parts plus past participle. Okay, now example children. The doctor is treating her for tooth problem. Passive, she is being treated for her tooth problems. Past continuous tense. Was, were, plus be, plus past participle. Let's have a look at the example. They were serving the lunch when the incident took place. Passive, the lunch was being served when the incident took place. Next one. Present perfect tense. Has, have, plus been, plus past participle. Okay, tsunami has caused a lot of destruction in Japan. Passive, a lot of destruction has been caused by tsunami in Japan. Past perfect tense, had plus been plus past participle, that comes to past perfect tense. The example, the team had made an important discovery. The important discovery has been made by, an important discovery has been made by the team. Future perfect tense. Will, shall, plus have been, plus past participle. That is future perfect tense. The example. She will have completed her assignment by tomorrow. Her assignment will have been completed by tomorrow. Imperative sentences. Let's have a look at this. Let plus object plus be plus past participle. Let is used to convert the active voice sentence into a passive voice sentence. With let sentences, the subject, you is not used. It is understood. Yes. Alternatively, we can also use the structure. Take a walk in the morning. You are advised to take a walk in the morning. Stop shouting. Somebody is ordering here. Passive. You are instructed or ordered to stop shouting. Why ordered? Because it is an order. In case the word phrase is there in active voice, you are requested is used to make it passive. Please do not disturb us. Somebody is requesting. Why? Because please is there. So you are requested not to disturb us. Interrogative sentences, that means asking questions. If the active sentence begins with question word, the passive sentence will begin with a question word. If the active sentence begins with who, the passive sentence will begin with by whom. Yes, and if the active begins with whom, the passive sentence will begin with who. The following is the common structure of passive voice of interrogative sentences. Am plus object or are plus object of the active verb plus past participle. Form of the verb plus by plus subject of the passive verb. Let's see. Who killed the snake? By whom was the snake killed? Next one, how did he assemble the computer? How was the computer assembled by him? Active, why did he send such an email? Passive, why was such an email sent by him? Double objects. Certain sentences contain two objects. In such a case, two passive sentences can be made using one object in each case. One of the two objects becomes a subject, the other one remains an object. This is in case of double objects. Active, my father gifted me a laptop. Passive, I was gifted a laptop by my father. or a laptop was gifted to me by my father. Verbs followed by prepositions. We can form passive sentences with clauses where the verb is followed by a preposition. Someone broke into their house and stole all the golden ornaments. Their house was broken into and all the golden ornaments were stolen. Active, they chopped down the dead tree. Passive, the dead tree was chopped down by them. I filled in the form. This is active. The form was filled by me. By me is understood. Even if you don't write, it is understood. That is passive. Change of voice from passive to active. We were doing active to passive. Now we are going to do passive to active. We are taught by Mr. Peter, passive. Mr. Peter Daniel teaches us English. So here we are changing passive voice into active voice. The meeting was presided over by the chairman. This is passive. The chairman presided over the meeting. You are requested to keep quiet. Please keep quiet. Use of passive voice in communication. We use passive voice to highlight the recipient of the action. The doer of the action becomes insignificant. That means not important. We may use passive voice when we feel the receiver of the action is more important, or if we don't know the identity of the doer, or the doer is not important. For example, there was a huge crowd and suddenly my wallet was snatched. That means by someone, which is understood. So it may be mentioned, it may not be mentioned. It is not that important to mention. Why? Because it is understood here. We can use passive voice without mentioning the agents in technical writings when the process is more important than the agent that does it. We may also use passive voice to appear more impersonal and authoritative. In the following example, the process is more important than the doer and the narration is impersonal. The mixture was then taken and poured into a flask containing nitrogen trichloride. Exercise. Let's have a look at exercise now. Complete the following passage by using the passive form of the verbs in the bracket. The age of computers dash us on the escalator of aspirations, but we dash rob of the sample charms like falling asleep. See, you have to use the correct form of the word given in the bracket. Read it very carefully and then do the exercise. Note down in your notebook and then only you have to do. Now answer. Check whether you got the answers correct. A, has thrown. B, have been robbed. C, be regained. And D, achieved. E, done. So if you have got any answer wrong, kindly do the correction. Convert the following sentences from active to passive. Children, first you have to go through the rules, then only you will be able to do. Why did she write such a letter? They clean the entire classroom. Keep quiet. I will have finished my work by tomorrow. The police is questioning the suspect. Write the answers. Now check whether you got the answers correct or not. Why was such a letter written by her? The entire classroom was cleaned by them. Next one. You are ordered to keep quiet. Why? Keep quiet is an order. So therefore you have to use the word ordered. My work will have finished by tomorrow. The suspect is being questioned by the police. Okay, children, very important, active voice and passive voice. Go through all the rules. Write down in your notebook. This is your assignment. And all the questions and answers, examples, whatever we have done in this session are all very important. What are you supposed to do? Yes, you're supposed to write down in your English notebooks. That's all. Thank you.